Who is the woman associated with the French Revolution?
Madame Tussaud, because she took facial masks, didn't she? Death masks,
yeah,
of the people.
It's an extraordinary story because she was the art teacher and indeed a waxworks modeller for the sister of Louis XVI. And so she was seen to be a royalist and her head was actually shaved in preparation for execution. And she was saved by a leading revolutionary who had been friendly with her before. And she was made to do the people's likenesses. And then she was asked to come to Britain to show them and was going to go back to France but had to stay because the Napoleonic Wars started and she wasn't able to return.
Who are these two?
So this is the King and Queen.
Those are actually the King and Queen of France.
It's Marie Antoinette and and the King, yeah.
Or the waxworks of them.
The waxworks.
I used to work in Madame Tussauds.
Oh, this is marvellous. Somebody who can out-anecdote Gyles, I like this.
I worked as a zombie, because my acting career got off to a really quick start. And you had to learn how to put all different latex on stuff and make your makeup really awful to be jumping out at people in this scary maze. But you learnt to wax, which was to stand where tourists were walking past you and you'd stay completely still and then just move a bit and people would cack themselves. And I got told after my second stint there that I was the scariest woman they'd ever had.
Now, Charles, I thought when you said you have personal experience of this that you were going to mention family connection.
This, seriously, is how I became really interested in this subject of the guillotine and executions, because my forebear, Jeremiah Brandreth, was a revolutionary and the last person to be beheaded in this country for treason.
I think we have a picture, actually, of Jeremiah.
There he is.
Part of the Pendrick Martyrs.
1817. He was a revolutionary. He began as a Luddite. He realised that the Industrial Revolution was going to make people lose their jobs. He was determined to overthrow the government of the day. And, anyway, he led this revolution up in Derbyshire. He was known as the Nottingham Captain and was arrested, put on trial, and was not just hanged, but he was then beheaded because he was a traitor.
Because they wanted to show the head. I mean, I think he was already dead by the time he was beheaded. Now, we were trying to see the family likeness in this, so we've done a little bit of photoshopping just to see how that would look. So there you are.
Uncanny.
I do think, darling, if you were ever beheaded, just as they lifted the head up, you'd be going, I've got one more story.
You know, the head can live on for another 15 seconds.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.